to study how cells communicate with each other, perhaps the best model organism nowadays is the fruit fly Drosophila melanogaster. Because in this model organism, you can manipulate every gene and to understand how the cells use these genes to communicate with each other and give rise always to the same final structure in the adult animal. So based on the fact that the same genes and principles are being used to construct a fly in a human being, the translational impact of a fruit fly in biomedicine is clear. We can now model human diseases in the flies and analyze at the molecular and cellular levels why a particular human disease is being induced. Understanding how the size of a leg, a wing, or an eye of a fruit fly is being controlled, we may be able to understand how the size of a hand, a head, or a liver in a human being is being controlled. In the lab, we are particularly interested in understanding how the same genes are being involved in the regulation of the normal growth, the normal size, normal development of a particular tissue, how the same genes are being used in cases of regeneration, and how exactly the same genes are being used to generate a tumor. Besides cancer, Drosophila is and will be a very good model system to understand other human diseases such as diabetes, neurodegenerative diseases, or behavioral diseases. In particular, our lab is very interested in understanding the connection between diabetes, defects in nutrition, and cancer. Which are the main reasons that drive me every day to the lab? There are two. One of them is a matter of knowledge, it's a matter of understanding better and better every day how the system works. And second, to teach the new generation of scientists into this very fascinating field. A few months ago, my 12-year-old daughter came home and brought this present to me. And that's the reason why I bring it this, because this means that also my family, which is also one of the major pillars of my life, understands that why and how important this fruit fly is for my life and my scientific research.